John Harbaugh started the press conference today being straight up, straightforward, no beating around the bush. He said Lamar Jackson and Gus Edwards both tested positive for COVID-19. And this comes after they said Lamar Jackson tested negative and 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 negative. Then he got one positive. So now he's on the list and he will be out for the next 10 days of training camp. It is unfortunate because he's missing time away from the guys. He's missing the team camaraderie. He's missing the vibe. He's missing the chemistry, both him and Gus Edwards. But it is, even though it's a very unfortunate situation, it's extremely unfortunate. This is the best case scenario that it could have been for anybody on the team getting it. This is the best case scenario. The fact that it's happening right now at the very, very, very beginning of training camp. This is the best case for this scenario. Because if it happened later, and if it happened in the regular season, we just don't want to even get into all that. So hopefully Lamar Jackson and Gus Edwards are both straight. Hopefully they're both good. But one thing too. Hopefully both of them don't have any long-term effects, because we have heard of that with enough people, with enough regular people, and with enough athletes as well, the long-term effects, because they have a very high motor, high energy job, and COVID can really drain your energy. So hopefully those guys can really be full go, healthy, and no lingering long-term effects. So shout out to Lamar, shout out to Gus Edwards, y'all boys, rest up. Now, football is a very, very, it's a nasty business. And regardless if you are ready or not as a football player, the show must go on, as they always say. And that's exactly what happened today at training camp. The show, it went on. They said that Trace McSorley, they said he had a pretty good day. They said the offense had a pretty good day overall, and the offense would probably be the winners today. They did make some nice comments about Brandon Stevens, said he made some nice plays, but they said the offense were pretty much the winners. Now, somebody from offense, and of course, I think they said it only happened 2 or 3 times. I mean, that is a lot for one practice, but again, it's better that it happens now in training camp and practice and all that than in the regular season. So please get it out your system, Bradley. Get it out your system. All the bad snaps, because they said it was 3 of them today. They said 2 of them were over Trace McSorley's head, and then 1 of them was really high, but Trace McSorley reached up and caught it. So it's, again, better that that happened now rather than later. So again, Get all the bad stuff out. Get it all out. And Trace is a little shorter than Lamar Jackson, so maybe that's why, but I know. It'll be fine, though, man. I hope. Anyway, Hollywood Brown was apparently very active today, catching a lot of deep passes. I think they said he caught 2 touchdowns, so that is a beautiful thing. They said James Prochet caught a deep pass. They said he got behind Jimmy Smith. So, okay, cool, nice. Go ahead, Prochet. Do your thing, baby. They said Miles Boykin, he ran some nice routes, but he had a drop. They said that it wasn't the best pass, though. So, hey, we'll see what happens with that. Said J.K. Dobbins continued to do his thing. I mean, what else did we expect? They said Devin Duvernay, he looked good. I did not hear anything about Sammy Watkins or Rashad Bateman. I know Rashad Bateman was there for sure, too. I didn't hear anything about Sammy Watkins being absent, but I didn't hear anything about those two. So, again, not concerned. And remember, y'all, whether something good is something good for the offense or something good for the defense or something good for special teams. Well, special teams, it ain't no overreacting with that, because we know them dudes. Yeah, y'all got it. But if you hear something good for either offense or defense during training camp, it's great. It's wonderful. It's amazing. But you don't put too much stock into it. Now, it's great. We want these guys to be looking good at training camp, because this is where it starts. But the real stuff happens on the field. It starts here, but the real stuff happens on the field. And that leads me to Mr. Hollywood Brown, who spoke to the media today very briefly. All the press today was only like 22 minutes. And some of that had wait time in there as we waited for the next person to speak. But it was a pretty short presser. Not really much out of it, but Hollywood did say something that had some significance. He spoke about Greg Roman's offense because he was asked, are there many changes? Are there many new things that have been added to the offense this year? And Hollywood said, well, there's some stuff here and there. But as far as he said, we're doing a lot of the same stuff. But I really did appreciate how Hollywood, he took ownership. Because we, of course, know the comments from last year about the soldiers and whatnot, and we know who they were directed to and whatnot. But Hollywood took ownership, and he talked about, hey, we need to get it done in practice first. And the more times we get it done in practice, that repetition, more times we get it done in practice, the more confidence that Greg Roman will have in us to do the same thing out there and call the plays when it's time, when it's game time. And that's true. That's true. That's with anything. Once you do something over and over again, you have that repetition with it. So you get more and more comfortable with it. So when it's crunch time, when you have to do that thing for real, when it's not practice time anymore, things can flow that much better. And that's very, very important. That's super important. So shout out to Hollywood. Again, glad he had a great day. And like John Harbaugh has been saying for years, he's been saying for years, it's all about stacking. Stacking great practices. That's what you got to do. And then, of course, it'll translate to the, well, you hope it'll translate to the field. You want it to translate to the field for everybody. Marlon Humphrey and Chuck Clark, they also spoke to the media. They needed one more guy to fill in for Lamar since he wasn't speaking to the media today, which is all good, though. But Marlon Humphrey, he was already scheduled to speak. It's supposed to be Hollywood, Humphrey, and Lamar. But, yeah, we know. But when Marlon Humphrey was speaking, he just talked about getting back to it. He talked about his family. He gave a shout-out to his mom, his dad, his brothers, his sisters, his entire family. I love how he talked about when if you had a bad game. If you had a bad game, he said it wasn't going to be any fun at the dinner table for you. Said it wasn't going to be fun. They will let you know. And for me, I appreciate that. I love that. I know there's some people who will be like, I don't want to. They wouldn't want to tell whether their kid had a bad game or something, or their friend or something, whether it's a bad game or they're doing something in not the best way. Some people don't like letting other people know, hey, you're doing a bad job. You did a bad job with that. That's not good. I love that. I appreciate that. I'm very straightforward with Carter. Not in a mean way, but I let him know, Carter, come on now, man. That wasn't good. It wasn't good because, in my opinion, I think that builds character and that lets them know, like, everything ain't gonna be peaches and cream in life. Everything ain't gonna be all these roses and everything's not gonna be all dreamy and da-da-da. Not that life is gonna be so bad or anything like that, but you got to be able to take that, too. You gotta have a good balance. And, of course, when he does good, I surely let him know that, too. So he gets a good balance of both. And it sounded like that's what Marlon Humphrey's parents and his family did with him. Because he said that his mom was like, he said there was always somebody in track that was faster than him. There was always somebody that was faster than him, that was better than him. But he said his mom told him, that's fine, but you, I promise you, you will outwork them. You are going to outwork them. And look where he is now. I think it pretty much worked out for him. But anyway, so shout out to Marlon Humphrey. Now, something that him and Chuck Clark talked about, shout out to Chuck Clark with the new cut. That's how I used to cut my hair, too, before I really knew how to cut it that much. But anyway, but Chuck Clark, he went bald. He cut the beard low. He said he keeping it clean. So I appreciate it, Chuck. Shout out to Chuck Clark. Anyway, something that both him and Marlon Humphrey said that really stuck out to me and something that we really got to appreciate and hope that it continues is Tavon Young and him being healthy. Marlon Humphrey talked about with Tavon Young, and Chuck Clark said the same thing with Tay-Tay being back, that this allows the defense to do multiple things. This allows them to do a lot more. Marlon Humphrey said he gets to go back to the outside, and Tay-Tay, of course, will be that slot corner. And Jimmy Zig, Marcus Peters, and it's just a beautiful thing. Health is a beautiful thing. And like we talked about in a previous video, that health in so many different positions for the Ravens, that's I think that's got to be our biggest concern as Ravens fans is health. That's it, the health. With the offensive line, Ronnie Stanley, we hope he's back healthy. With the tight ends, Nick Boyle, we hope he's back healthy. With the wide receivers, we hope Sammy Watkins can stay healthy. With the cornerbacks, we hope Jimmy Smith and Tavon Young can stay healthy. That's our biggest concern is just health across the board. So hopefully these boys can just be able to stay healthy. Because it is a long season, and the season just got longer with them adding another game. Calais Campbell talked about, and he was looking ahead, which I appreciate and I like, and that's planning ahead. Hopefully the Ravens can find themselves in a position to do that. We'll see. But Calais Campbell was thinking ahead when he talked about, hey, with the longer season, they asked him, oh, what are you doing to stay in shape and prepare for the longer season? He said, oh, all we can do is just embrace it. But hopefully we're in a position, well, well, hopefully we're in a position, because his voice is deeper than that. I can't even talk as deep as his voice is. But he said that hopefully the Ravens are in a position to where they can have the number one seed so they can have the bye week. So that can sort of give them another break as they head into the postseason. So I like that thinking. Hopefully they get it. If they don't, okay. As long as they make it in, that's the biggest thing. So, yeah. Anyway, that's where we're at right now with the Ravens. Training camp continues. It was really nice to see fans out there. It was great to just hear that and then to see the videos of the fans and stuff. So shout out to all of y'all that'll be attending the training camp. Shout out to all of y'all that'll be attending the open practice and just getting to see the guys live. Unfortunately, won't get to see Lamar Jackson there, which it sucks. It sucks because that's a quarterback. That's the team starting quarterback. But still, go out there, have a good time, and make the most of it. I love y'all, team. Keep it clean. I appreciate y'all, and we out.